Hi everyone, it's Vicky here, and today I'm super excited as this is a collaboration video with my YouTube friend Lindsay, also known as the Frugal Crafter. I'm sure you all know her, but if not, make sure to check out her YouTube channel for amazing crafty videos. This collaboration is a part of her event called 12 Days of Craftmas, and she is having more YouTube guests lined up. Today we are both making Christmas-themed cards, so let's get started. For my card today, I will be using this adorable stamp set by Waffle Flowers, which is called Stocking, and there is also matching dies available. So first of all, I am going to stamp with Memento Tuxedo Black ink some of those images included in the set on white cardstock. Now I am using Memento ink because I will be using my Copic markers to color all the images later on. And as always, you can find a full list of all the supplies that I'm using today just below the video in the description area, as well as on my blog. So I am stamping the stocking as well as a couple of gifts, and there are more little bits and pieces in this set that can fill in the stocking. So today I decided to use my Copic markers to color everything, but at this stage of the card you can use your favorite type of coloring. It can either be watercoloring, it can be alcohol markers like I'm doing today, your pencils, whatever you like. I am also making sure that I don't go outside the edges because I will be using the dies to cut out the images. But if you are using your scissors, then you can make your life easier and go outside of the line since it will not matter. I'm not going to bore you with copy coloring throughout the video. I am just going to let you see how I colored the stocking and move on from there. So now it's time to cut out all those little images. There is a matching die set for this stamp set that comes with all those little tiny dies that perfectly match in each and every shape. So I will be placing one on top of every image, and I am securing it using some post-it tape so that will make sure that the dies will not move as I pass it through my Sizzix machine. Now, if you don't have the matching die, that's not really necessary. You can use your scissors to cut out the images. After all, they are not that difficult to cut out. Also note that when you are using matching dies, that leaves a white border all around the images, while when you are using your scissors, you can cut out the image right where the black line is. So it depends on the look you want to have. I have also cut out with one of the dies a loop for the stocking, which I am now going to stamp. And now it's time to add all those stocking stuffers inside the stocking. I will be using my tape runner to assemble everything. And all you have to do now is to stick the stocking on top of your card base and you have a card ready. All you have to do is to add the sentiment. But I decided to take it a step further and I am creating with those frames a nice border from where I can hang the stocking. So I have this white border all around. I am first going to stamp the sentiment, which is going to be Merry Christmas, and I will stamp it with Versamark ink and white emboss it. I am being very careful at this stage since I want to make sure that the sentiment is going to be shown through that frame. I am using my embossing tool and this applies a little bit of powder which eliminates static electricity, so the embossing powder later on will only stick where it's supposed to. The embossing powder that I will be using is by WOW and it's a bright opaque white. My card base for today is a standard card that's 4.25 by 5.5. It is side folded and I have used red cardstock for my card. I really love using traditional Christmas colors for my Christmas cards. And actually this is my favorite season of the year when it comes to card making, because making Christmas cards is really my favorite. Now I have the sentiment embossed and it's time to assemble my card. I will be using some foam tape at the back of this frame, and no, I'm not going to turn this into a shaker card, I just want to have a raised frame, which is going to give a little bit of dimension on my card. The foam tape that I am using is not very bulky, it's not too thick, so although it adds a little bit of dimension, it is super easy to mail in a standard envelope. I am also adding some foam tape at the back of the stocking, and I will be using some baker's twine to hang my stocking from the loop. And my card is now finished. All that's left to do is to add some finishing touches, and just because I love some shine on any Christmas card, I am adding just a little bit of shine with my Wink of Stella glitter pen. And then I will also be using some of these silver stars, which I am going to stick on the background in random places. I am using my matte medium, which is in a fine tip applicator, which makes my job really easy. So that was my Christmas card for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment, as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. Here are some close-up photos of the card. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel already, make sure to do so, because this is the way to tell me that you love my videos and you want to see more. Now go ahead and click on the screen right now so you can visit Lindsay's channel, The Frugal Crafter, and see what she has created to inspire you. If you are watching from a mobile device, you can find a link to her blog just below the video in the description area. Thank you all for watching!